Hi, I'm here for you today.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. So what brings you in today?
So last Friday, I was washing the dishes and all of a sudden my right arm, well first it started with my hand, but then my right arm just got really weak.
Okay. So this started last Friday?
Yes.
And you were washing the dishes when it happened?
Yes.
Have you ever noticed this happen before?
No, never.
This is your first time?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, have you ever, since then, has it happened again?
No.
No. Okay. So, when this happened, did you feel any weakness, any pain, or was it just loss of sensation?
I felt weak. And then I actually, it did feel numb too.
Numb?
And like, I almost couldn't move it.
Okay. Did you try anything to make it better?
Well, right when it started, I tried to pick up a dish again, but then that didn't work. So then I went and sat down and I just kind of rested my arm on the couch.
Okay.
And like, it felt better then,
mm-hmm.
but it went away in a few minutes.
Okay.
So then I guess that made it better.
Okay. Did anything make it worse besides trying to pick up another dish?
No, just pretty much, I think just standing and then also just trying to pick up the dish, I was just so shocked.
Okay. And how long would you say that this episode lasted?
Only a few minutes.
Okay. And on a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the worst, how uncomfortable was this for you?
It was very uncomfortable. I never experienced weakness like that before, so it scared me.
Right.
I'd probably say like a 9 or a 10 almost.
Okay. Do you have any allergies to medicine, environment, anything?
No.
No? Do you take any medications?
I take my one-a-day vitamin.
Okay.
And then I take Crestor for my high cholesterol.
Okay. You take that orally?
Yes.
Every day?
Yes.
And what's the dose, do you know?
250 milligrams.
Okay. I'm going to ask you about your childhood.
Okay.
If you can recall, when you were a child, did you have the mumps?
No.
The measles?
No.
Rubella?
No.
Scarlet fever?
No.
Rheumatic fever? Chickenpox?
No.
No. Polio?
No.
Did you have recurrent ear infections?
No.
No. Did you have vaccinations for most of the diseases I named?
Yes.
Yeah, pretty much all of them. Okay, that's good. As an adult, have you had hypertension?
No.
No? Diabetes?
No.
Any cancers?
No, thank goodness.
No. Coronary artery disease?
No.
HIV, AIDS? No. Diabetes? Thyroid disorders?
No.
Kidney disorders?
No.
No, okay. Have you had any accidents in your childhood or your adulthood?
In my childhood, I broke my right arm.
Okay.
When I was in first grade. That healed pretty good.
Did you have to be hospitalized or have any surgery for that?
Nope.
No? And the outcome, you haven't had any complications with that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's good. So no other accidents or injuries?
Nope.
No? Have you had to be hospitalized?
No.
Any surgeries?
Wisdom teeth.
Wisdom teeth, when was that?
That was when I was, I was about 19 years old.
19?
It was a long time ago.
did you heal nicely?
Actually, no. I had dry sockets.
Oh, no.
It's horrible.
What did they do to treat that?
They put medicated clothes down into the hole.
Oh.
And I had to keep it there for a few days.
Oh.
And then that was horrible. But then after that, it healed. It healed pretty good.
Okay. That's good. Okay, so have you spoken to anybody or been hospitalized for any psychiatric illnesses?
No.
No. Do you see an OBGYN?
Yes.
Yes. Do you get pap smears regularly?
Yep.
Yes. Okay. When did you get your first period?
When I was in sixth grade.
Sixth grade.
So I was like 11 or 12.
has it been pretty much regular since then?
Yep.
Have you ever been pregnant?
No.
No.
Or yes.
Yes.
I have two children.
Oh.
Sorry, I'm just so used to saying no.
Have you, when was that?
Well, my oldest daughter, she is now 22, and then my son is 18.
Okay. So, were you hospitalized for those, or did that happen at home?
Oh, I guess that would be my hospitalizations, yes.
Okay. And did you have any complications? Did you have a vaginal delivery?
Very vaginal.
Okay. So, and do you still get your period?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Have you never had any, or did you have any abortions or miscarriages?
Nope.
No? Okay. Okay, I'm gonna go into your family history. So you said you have children.
Yep.
Do they have any serious medical conditions?
Nope, they're very healthy.
No? Okay, that's good. What about your parents? Are they alive?
Both my parents are alive still. My mom is 82. She actually had a stroke when she was in her 60s, and I was explaining my symptoms to her, and she said they kind of sounded similar to hers, but hers were a lot worse.
Okay.
And then my, but she recovered from that very good. And then my dad, he's 85, and he had a heart attack, and he has diabetes.
Okay.
Doing better now.
Okay, so I'm gonna run through a list of some disorders. You or have already mentioned some, so I'm just gonna make sure I've got them all. So you mentioned diabetes,
mm-hmm.
coronary artery disease,
yeah.
and a stroke.
Yes.
Okay, so do you have any other family history of hypertension?
My mom has hypertension.
Your mom has hypertension. Okay, any cancers?
No.
No COPD?
No.
No thyroid disorders?
Nope.
Kidney?
Nope.
Renal?
Okay.
Okay. Any mental illnesses?
Nope.
Suicides?
Nope.
Substance abuse?
My dad used to like to drink a little when I was younger, but he's good now.
Okay.
He's with his old age.
Any seizures?
No.
No? Okay. That's good. So I'm going to go into your social history. Where were you born?
I was born in Philadelphia.
Who lives at home with you?
It's just me and my husband right now because my kids are off to college.
Oh, okay. Well, what kind of home do you live in?
I live in a two-story home.
Two stories. Mm-hmm. Have you noticed any difficulty with the stairs?
Not usually, no.
No? Okay. What is your occupation?
I am a school teacher.
A school teacher? How long have you been doing that?
Oh my goodness. I've been a teacher since I was 22 years old.
Oh, okay.
So it's been about 30 plus years almost.
Wow. So you enjoy your job?
Oh, I love it.
So your stress level, what would you say?
During the school year, it's a little stressed because the kids are kind of crazy,
mm-hmm.
but in the summer, it's pretty good.
Okay. So when you come home from work, do you and your husband have a good relationship?
Yes.
So you have a good support system?
Yes.
Okay, that's good. Let me talk about your habits. How many hours would you say you sleep per night?
I try to at least get 7 or 8 hours per night.
Okay, that's good. How many drinks would you say you had in a week or a month?
Well, I do like my red wine.
Okay.
We like to drink it. My husband and I like to have it at dinner time.
Okay.
So maybe a few times a week.
Okay.
Depending on what we have for dinner.
Okay. Do you use tobacco?
No.
Any illicit drugs?
No.
No? Okay. Do you have smoke detectors, carbon monoxide detectors in your house?
Yep.
Do you use a seatbelt?
Yes.
A helmet if you ride your bike?
I couldn't tell you the last time I rode a bike, but yes, if I would.
Okay, that's good. All right. I'm going to now ask you some questions about your sexual history, which I go through with all of my patients.
Okay.
So how long have you and your husband been married?
We've been married for 34 years.
Okay. And are you and your husband sexually active?
Yes.
Yes. Are you sexually active outside of your marriage?
No.
No? Okay. That's good. All right, I'm gonna ask you just a series of questions. Just yes or no questions, okay? I'm gonna start with your usual weight. Is that where you usually are, your weight on your chart?
I actually gained some weight this past summer.
You did? How much would you
About
say?
10 pounds.
10 pounds in over the summer, like 3 months period?
From May till now.
Okay, and what would you contribute to that?
Oh, definitely not exercising as much.
Not exercising.
And eating a little more.
Okay.
And it's making my cholesterol go up.
Okay.
So I've been watching that too.
Okay, I see. Okay, have you noticed within the past 6 months any fever?
No.
Any night sweats?
No.
Chills?
No.
Fatigue?
I have been feeling a little more tired lately. And then especially after that incident, I felt like exhausted.
Really? For how long after, would you say?
Well, it happened at dinner time, and I went to bed, like, soon after that.
Okay. And when you woke up the next day, did you pretty much feel back to normal?
Yeah, I felt fine then the next day.
Okay. Have you had any weakness?
Just that.
Just that one.
Yeah, just with my arm.
Okay.
And then, yeah.
Any malaise?
Oh, I've been feeling okay.
Okay. About your skin, have you noticed any color or texture changes?
No.
No rashes?
No.
Easy bruising?
No.
Dryness?
Mm-mm.
Oiliness? Is it itchy?
No.
No? Any lumps?
No.
Lesions? Any changes to your hair or your nails?
No.
Okay. Some about your eyes is, do you wear contacts other than glasses or just glasses?
I have contacts, but I don't usually wear them.
You don't usually wear them. Do you know when, your last eye exam was?
Last year sometime.
Last year, and the results were normal or?
They pretty much, my eyes have stayed the same in the last, like, 3 years.
Okay. So have you noticed any vision changes?
No.
Any double vision?
No.
Blurry vision? Pain,
mm-mm.
Redness,
mm-mm.
Sensitivity to light, no? Okay, I'm just going to go back to your symptom and ask you, so you said that was the first and only time it's ever happened to you?
Yes.
Okay, have you ever had any fainting episodes?
No, but I did feel like really lightheaded when it happened. That's why I was like, you know what, I better just sit down.
Right. Okay, any dizziness?
I felt a little dizzy too.
Dizzy? This is just during when this happened?
Yeah, no other time, just like when that started, like when I started to feel the weakness, and then it's like I got a little lightheaded, and then it was even more weakness.
Okay.
And then that's when I really started to get a little dizzy too.
Okay, well, I'm going to look into your symptoms so that we can get a good diagnosis for you, because I know this is probably scary for you. So we're going to do everything that we can to help you.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.